Welcome to today's edition of Space Station Live. All six crew members have a fairly busy day today. A lot of science activities going on that's being overseen primarily from NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. Once the crew members finish their early morning chores after wake up, they divide and conquer and head off in different directions. Wakata spent a good deal of the first half of his day in the Japanese science laboratory, Kibo, the Japanese word for hope, conducting some experiments, checking on others, and joining his colleagues for an early morning long-distance teleconference with the ground to set the stage for all of the activities on board. In the U.S. lab, much of the time spent today is on breaking down some experiments that have already been underway, including some work on the in-space experiment, a colloidal fluids experiment, also working with the facet experiment known as investigation of mechanism, a faceted cellular array growth, investigating the phenomena of solid-liquid interfaces for crystallization. The crew members also working on a crystal growth mechanism, a crystal growth experiment known as ice crystal, which is essentially studies the stability of ice crystals in supercooled water, including antifreeze. This designed to help understand how these different types of solutions are required to be modified for use on Earth, and what we can learn in the microgravity and space to more purify such crystals. So those are just a few of the experiments that the crew members are interfacing with throughout their day today. They also, of course, have some other activities scheduled, a lot of human research experiments. Periodically, the crew members test each other for their eye acuity, if you will, and today marks one of those days where the periodical checking of their ocular health through blood pressure and tonometry, which is essentially an intraocular pressure test that's conducted on the crew members' eyes to understand changes in their eyes and their visual acuity throughout the duration of their stay aboard the station. So a busy day for crew members in and around that. They, of course, perform their routine exercise. The newest crew members are allotted some time for continuing to adapt to the station and learn their new environment, which is their home for the next 6 months aboard the International Space Station.